Our stories used to be so simple. We had a beginning, a middle, and an end. But ever since we moved to this awful city, everything's gotten so confused.
Look, I didn't kill anyone.
And I'm supposed to just believe you. Snow. I just want you to be careful. I almost lost you once, and...
I'm not yours to lose. I'm not going to be an errand girl for Crane anymore.
She looks like Holly.
It's not Holly. It's her sister, Lily.
She was hooking to pay down debt. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the Puddin' and Pie.
My name is Nerissa.
Well, Nerissa, I've got some questions. The open arms.
Oh my God! What is it?
It's Crane. Fucking rat.
Crane? Ugh, God, you think you'd know a person. Bigby, you have to tell her.
I know!
What's going on? What did you find up there? You know, other than the...
Not now.
I have a right to know. If my wife is...
Honey.
Shit!
Crane's been... Whoa! Bigby, calm down. Everything's going to be fine. Okay, it's going to be fine.
Will someone please explain this to me?
Crane has been stalking Snow White.
That perverted little fucker might be after Snow. I need to find her right now.
Okay, it's going to be okay. Where did you see her last? Did she say where she was going?
She took Holly to the business office to prepare for the funeral.
Lily's funeral?
Yeah.
How do you know?
I was just at the Trip Trap, and I heard Gren telling some folks about a funeral at the Buckingham
Bridge.
The
Trip Trap? Are you drinking?
When?
Right now. They were on their way out.
Bigby! Wait.
What?
Snow's been through a lot. There are things she doesn't talk about. Just please be careful. When you tell her...
What are you trying to say?
You know how you felt when you saw that picture? Well, it's going to be much worse for her. Just remember that.
If you're here, then you were part of a very special circle. People she trusted and cared for. I won't, offend you by claiming one day that the pain of losing Lily will ever subside. I know as well as you that it will never subside. But I also know that the memory of Lily will sustain as well. And it will,
I'll miss worrying
in time,
about you.
Equal
I'll miss
in
our
strength
fights.
To our mourning
I'll
for
miss
loss.
You.
And it
Holly.
Is in that spirit that I'd like to talk about what you've all been so grateful to share with me. Your memories.
Now you will never die
how
from indifference.
Stubborn
lead a
and
tedious
patient,
life.
Rash
Goodbye,
and
sweetheart.
Thoughtful.
Thanks
she
for
carried
everything.
A torch for the old ways.
Vivian.
For tradition, for pageantry. And most of all, it seems
you were a big, bright, shining star in this shithole of a town. And I miss you already.
Being around them. Gren. In good times and bad. I never met Lily, but from what I've been told, I know in my heart that she would have liked to be here tonight. And now we'll have our, moment of silence. Thank you. Bigby, is everything okay?
No, not you.
Holly, it's...
He wasn't fucking invited.
Holly, wait.
He has no right to be here. Not after what he did.
Holly, I'm sorry, but I had to come.
You throw my sister down the witching well, and you have the nerve to show your face here? After you lie and say you'll check first?
Holly, wait. That was Crane. Just Crane. He disposed of Lily's body before Bigby could do anything about it. I'm telling you the truth.
Don't cover for him.
But this genuinely wasn't his fault.
You can't tell me Bigby gives a shit about this.
Holly, it's gonna be okay.
I'm sorry, Holly. I didn't know he put her down the witching well.
Holly, Bigby's trying in his own way, and I'm sure he has a very good reason for being here. But this one isn't on him.
Why are you here anyway? And don't say it's because you care about this.
Everything okay?
I just came to pay my respects, Holly. I don't mean any harm.
Oh, really? You have no respect you can pay. You don't care about any of us.
Okay, okay, look. Bigby and I are going to have a little chat far away from the ceremony, all right? Look, Holly, I know how this must...
No, you don't know how this must feel. You have no idea. Don't fuck anything up. Don't bother anybody. And when the first sign of trouble comes, and it will come because you're a goddamn walking trap for it, I want you the fuck out of here. You hear me?
Holly, I didn't even want to crash this, okay? I had to, because of Snow. I'll be out of here soon.
See that you are.
Let's just continue, okay?
This is such total fucking bullshit.
Let's go, Holly.
It's your turn to talk.
I know you didn't come here to pay your respects, so whatever it is better be wildly important. It's been hard enough making a connection with these people. When you pull this kind of stuff, it just resets the clock.
Crane murdered Lily.
What?
I followed a lead to this shithole motel, the Open Arms. Crane had a room there, and he's been taking prostitutes, or at the very least Lily, and making her look like you while he was, you know... The bed was covered in blood. I know it was him.
This is... I don't even know what to say right now. I really don't. I'm just trying everything I can right now to not picture it. To not picture him.
I'm sorry, Snow. And I'm sorry I had to be the one to tell you.
You're sure this is what happened? This is what he's been doing? Because please, Bigby, don't confuse things. Deposing Crane would be the next step. And if we get this wrong, it would mean more than our jobs. We'd get kicked out of Fabletown for messing all of this up so badly.
Crane has been taking photos, Snow. Lots of photos.
Photos that show him...
He's been recording his visits with Lily.
God. Look, let's go back to the business office. I doubt Crane's there at this hour, but we need to talk. And this isn't the place. Snow? Narissa? What is it?
I'm sorry, but Holly's asking for you.
Are they starting the burn?
Yes. Everyone who spoke should really be present for this part. She's kind of distraught. You're not leaving yet, are you?
2 minutes. I don't mean to be,
No, I understand.
It's just that something's come up.
Are you okay? You don't have to do this right now.
I'll be fine.
How'd it go? At the motel? Did you find anything? No?
I did. It helped a lot. Thanks.
Nerissa!
Yeah, coming!
Constable? Wait, wait, wait. Easy now, girl. You know how this goes. The first thing in a visit, you say, how do you do? How do you do? That way, it's proper.
Now is really not the time for whatever you Jergovs are planning to do.
Well, isn't that the thing of it? Plans. Except it isn't our plans you should be concerning yourself with. I'm still hurting, you know, from our talk in the cell. And I'll be honest, I'd love nothing more than to carve a sweet poem right into your face for the suffering you've caused me. But I am a professional, and we're here for a job. We'll snip to the chase for all sakes. A little bird told us that you're fit to go after Crane. And you see, we have an interest in that particular boy. So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone. Just take a little vacation is all. Don't even have to go anywhere. Just sit in your office and whistle to heaven for a few short days.
You're trying to pull this shit at a funeral? We can deal with this later.
No, not later. Later's too late. Right now. So what's it gonna be? We have a deal? You leave Crane alone and we leave you to yours? Brother, speak your mind. Fastly now. What's it gonna be?
Yeah, fine. I'll leave Crane alone. Just get out of here.
Pleasure to hear it.
Ladies, gentlemen, invertebrates, please, rest easy. This is not...
What the hell is going on?
What's happening?
Very sorry to impose, but we only had a deal to work out with Bigby. And we're happy to report that everything went smoothly. So if you'll just allow us to get out of your hair...
Bigby, what is he talking about?
Never you mind that. It ain't any of your...
What deal?
Settle down now.
They want me to leave Crane alone.
Crane?
Oh, now you shouldn't have done that, old boy. Really. That wasn't right, telling everyone our dealings.
What did I tell you? What did I say?
Ollie?
You think you motherfuckers could come here uninvited? You think you could just fucking interrupt Lily's funeral?
Calm down, darling. It was just a simple business transaction.
You fucking freaks are not getting away with this.
Holly, don't move.
Yeah, listen to your lady, love.
It's not worth it, Holly. They'll leave on their own.
Yeah, let's spare all the fuss. It's just a dead hole.
I'm gonna kill you!
Holly!
Holly!
I got it, damn!
I did as well as I could to take out the buckshot, but there's still some shards left embedded in your shoulder. They'll eventually worm their way out on their own, but until they do, you're gonna be sore.
Bigby, Dr. Swinehart was appointed Fabletown physician for a reason.
It's okay. There's only one thing you have to take away from all this. Take it easy. Don't go looking for any more fights. Keep strain off your heart. And try and get some rest.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
Is she?
She's fine, Bigby. I had everyone that got wounded sent home. Holly refused to let me see where she lived, so I left her and Grendel back at her bar with a dose of juniper and spring water. Just remember what I said. The stitches won't hold up if you continue to act like you normally do. Everything in moderation. And eat more chicken. Your blood pressure's through the proverbial roof.
I'll try to.
All right then. Very good.
Business office. I know. I'll have to call you back. The town is starting to find out.
Well, I'll leave you two to it then. Miss White? Bigby?
So, to recap...
Crane watched me through the magic mirror uncover his room at the Open Arms, and then he smashed it so we couldn't use it ourselves to go after him. And we know this because Bufkin was drinking in the rafters. That about cover it?
And once he puts all the pieces back together, it'll be easy to catch Crane. So, I guess that's the plan, currently. But I don't know.
There's no other leads. This is it. Just wait for the mirror.
Yeah. What the hell is going on? Just... I don't know what the Tweedles get out of this. I don't know if Crane sent them. I don't know if... I mean, this is gonna sound crazy, but... Do you really think Crane did it? Everything points to him. I get it. But do you really think he killed those women? Because it's just... It's incomprehensible to me.
I'm as confused as you are, to be honest. I don't know. It just doesn't make sense.
He was a conniver, a coward, a liar. And I'll always hate him for that. And I'll hate him for how he held me in his thoughts. But murdering prostitutes? Ow! Everything okay over there?
Yes, Miss White. Just cut myself on a piece of the glass. Nothing to worry about.
Thanks for tonight, by the way. That could have gone really terribly. I mean, even worse than it did. I'm glad you were there.
I just feel bad for Holly, really.
Yeah. Time heals everything eventually. At least, I hope so, for her sake. Can I, ask you a question? It's kind of personal. And I don't want to offend you, but after tonight, it's on my mind.
Sure.
It's just, when stuff hits the fan, like it did tonight, it feels like before we came to the city. It feels kind of like home. And I've heard it said that maybe in some tiny little bottled up way deep inside, you kind of enjoy it when things go wrong. Because it gives you an excuse to just, you know, stop pretending.
Fuck no, I don't enjoy it. Are you kidding me? It's horrible what happened tonight. I wish it didn't happen.
I shouldn't have said anything. Forget that I did.
Guys? We have a problem.
What is it?
I can't finish the mirror. It's missing a piece.
What do you mean, missing a piece?
Yes, it's not here.
Crane must have taken a shard with him.
Oh, I can't believe this.
I saw Crane pick something up after he smashed it. I'm sorry, I didn't realize what it was until now.
Well, the mirror can't work unless it's whole.
Well, that's not entirely true.
Or what, Bufkin? What? We sit around and wait until it mends itself? We have no idea how long that will take. We're just gonna have to do this the hard way.
I'm just saying, waiting is an option.
No. We can't depend on the mirror.
What exactly is the hard way?
We'll look through his things, his desk, everything. He had to have left something that tells us where he's going. He's a neat freak, but he was never that smart.
Smart enough to take a piece of the mirror? We can still solve this ourselves. I know that
Never mind that. Come help me look.
Hi, Mr. Bigby. I can still help you catch Crane, you know.
Oh, yeah?
Yes. I saw him jump on the telephone before he left. He called up somebody. He said he needed to see his witch, or that he would need to get to the witch for that, whoever that is.
His witch?
Yes, it sounded like the one he got his snow glamours from.
You didn't see anything else, did you?
No, not especially.
Look, the whole mirror thing, it's not your fault, right?
You mean it?
Yeah.
I'll just see if I can do anything about this.
You do that. Here that was torn out.
Oh, yeah? Bufkin, do you know what was here?
It's a ring, at least. Every magical item not retained in the armory is assigned to someone in Fable Town. It must be this witch he is going to see.
Wait, what witch?
Bufkin overheard Crane set up a meeting with a witch.
Well, yes, it sounded like the one he got his, You, Glamour's from. It must be about this ring.
Why not mention this before?
No one asked me.
Bufkin!
And I'm hungover. I'm sorry. He set the meeting at 2 a.m. tonight.
What's going on? Is the mirror fixed yet?
Bluebeard, this isn't the time.
Is the mirror fixed or isn't it? You called me to...
I called just to see if you knew where Crane could be, and that was it, okay? And I'm sorry I said anything more than that.
Well, you did, and I know. The cat's out of the bag. So, can we find the dull pervert or not?
I tried to, but...
This isn't your concern.
Oh, it isn't?
No, and frankly, it's none of your business.
None of my business? Crane's the murderer. He escaped. It seems he spoiled your every attempt at locating him. And now it's none of my business?
We don't know if he's the murderer.
Oh, please. Of course he is.
Look. This just isn't the time. He took a piece of the mirror, so we can't use it.
The only thing we know is that Crane's going to see a witch at 2 o'clock.
A.M. or P.M.?
A.M.
Listen, Bluebeard, you're not a part of this.
I don't think you're in any position to turn away help.
Why do you even care about this?
Why? I'm invested in this enterprise we call Fable Town. Literally invested. Since it's mostly my money that keeps the whole thing running. And tonight I hear that Crane has been killing fables? And there's no system in place to catch him?
Look, we know that Crane is going to see a witch, and it's to acquire a magic ring.
What's the ring?
We don't know what it does or who it's assigned to since Crane tore its page out of the book.
This farce was your ridiculous idea for a plan. I mean, who put you in charge in the first place?
Fixing the mirror was the most logical
thing! You're a secretary! He's the sheriff, and none of you are chosen to run this office. Who elected you to make these decisions?
Nobody, but that
doesn't... Who elected her to spend my money?
Well, I've been doing that unofficially for years.
Snow can obviously handle this, so let's drop it.
Well then, excuse me for having the Commonwealth in mind.
All right, let's just look on the bright side. We know Crane is going to see the witch that's been supplying him black market glamours.
Thanks to me.
And that he'll be there at 2. So that gives us a few short hours to find out who it is and where they live and get them all at once.
And a few shorter hours the more you babble about it.
We haven't been the ones babbling.
2 a.m. Piece of cake.
Since Lily used the glamours, she'd have known who the witch was. And I don't think Holly's burned her things yet. It would probably have the address or a phone number or something.
And Bigby is free to go there if he likes. But I think the question you should be asking is just what do the 2 Tweedles know about this?
It doesn't matter what they know. After tonight, they'd never go to their office.
They're not smart enough to try and go anywhere else.
The Trip Trap is the better option to track the witch down. That has to be our focus.
Look, chances are I'll have to swing by both anyways.
No, chances are you won't have time.
I don't really care what you 2 do. I'm going to his apartment.
What? You can't just go up there.
And why the hell not?
We already looked for the key, remember? I don't know where it is.
Then I'll pick the blasted lock! I've wasted enough time waiting for the mirror to find him. I won't waste any more.
You just can't go up there alone, all right?
I've no interest in nicking his drapes, my dear, if that's what concerns you.
What concerns me is you traipsing through possible evidence.
Oh, now it's evidence. Before you had no interest, and now it's a crime scene.
Bluebeard, just stay out of it, all right? You'll just mess things up further.
They can't get any more messed up.
We have to find the witch, Bluebeard, since that's where he's going.
Or the sniveling weasel chickened out. Never went anywhere. And is upstairs right now in his pitiful penthouse, crafting a fort out of couch cushions. Look, this is how a smart person would do it. So this is how we're going to do it. Wherever you go, I'll go to the other.
I don't like you going anywhere unsupervised. He's up to something. I don't know what it is, but we don't have the time to really worry about it now. Where are you gonna go, Bigby?
So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone.
I'd love to join you, but there's some business I need to attend to.
No, I'm better off dealing with things alone. I don't need sympathy and I don't need charity.
Dee and Dumb must know where he is. I should go to their office first.
Perfect, and I'll go to Crane's apartment.
I'll look up their address. I hope you know what you're doing.
Excuse me.
Oh, hi. Sheriff Bigby. Great to see you. I don't know if you remember me. I've, seen you around, but you may have forgotten.
I know who you are, Flycatcher. You've worked at the Woodlands for how many years now?
I think I've lost count. But you know, Crane, let me go recently.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I mean, it's no big deal. So, what brings you here? I mean, can I help you with anything? Are you here to see one of the brothers? Dee or Dumb? They're in here right now. I'm not sure when they'll be back.
You seen Crane around?
Not around here. I saw him leave the Woodlands earlier, but I'm not supposed to bother him. I don't really think he likes me. It's been a quiet night so far. I think the twins are out, probably working on a case. Sometimes I don't see them for days. They gave me the job after Crane told me to get lost. He said I was just in the way.
Where's their office?
Oh, right this way. I was going there next anyway. I can let you in if you want. You can wait for them there.
Sure. Thanks.
No problem.
I'm gonna have to take a look around.
Well, I guess that would be okay.
I wasn't really asking for permission.
Right. You're the sheriff. I just don't want to get in trouble or anything. I'm sure it's fine. I mean, they never told me not to let you in.
Just keep to the back, out of the way, all right?
Right.
You know about this?
No.
Dear Brother D, I think we should get ourselves a dog. Sincerely, Brother Dunn. He actually mailed this?
They do have their quirks.
This is pointless. Dear Brother Dunn, I hate dogs and you know it. Sincerely, Brother D. Couple of freaks.
I know these guys can come off abrasive at times, but they aren't so bad once you get to know them. And they really care about helping people. They're kind of loud at times, but you get used to it. I guess they have to be, in their line of work.
How do you mean they help people?
They're detectives. Anyone can come in here with a problem and they'll do their best to fix it. The way Dee explains it, it's like if someone lost their cat, well, they could hire them to, you know, track it down. Or like sometimes, they get packages for people. They can be like couriers, you know?
For who?
All kinds. Come to think of it, I don't really know where they keep them. Anyways, I'm just saying, you just don't know them like I do.
Sure, Flycatcher. Let's see if they got a file on Crane. Beauty's in debt to the Crooked Man? Shit. Detective Brannigan? Keep an eye on her. Them to look for a photo? So that's why they were at her apartment. And the woodsman's place.
See, I knew you wouldn't find anything. Anything of interest, anyways. They're detectives, like I said.
Just stay out of this. I have work to do.
I'm just saying.
Look, just trust me on this. Tweedledee and Dumb are not nice. They're not helping anyone.
Well, they helped me.
Okay, great. They helped you. It's one person. Now, please, just let me concentrate here. Ichabod Crane. He owes the Crooked Man money. Shit. How is he planning to pay this all back? Request for property acquisition. Further details filed under Donkey Skin. Why did he want it back so badly?
Find anything?
Not what I need.
What if you're wrong about them?
I'm not.
They're misunderstood, sure, but that doesn't mean everything people say about them is true. I mean, you know, like when I think about it, you guys aren't that different. You help people, and they help people. Not that it's any of my business, but I just wanted to say, you know, give them a chance.
Is that what you think?
Bigby?
Shit. There's something here. I know there is. Has to be.
Why would there be anything
to... Because they're lying to you, okay, Flycatcher? That's why. They aren't detectives. They're hired guns. Hitmen.
Bigby, what happened to your...
You want to know what this is? This is them showing up to Lily's funeral with fucking shotguns.
I'm sorry. I didn't know.
Look, Flycatcher, I know you like them, but they're a part of whatever's happening here. They're bad guys. I didn't mean to...
There's a door behind this file cabinet. Now, I don't know what they keep back here, but it might be what you're looking for. Well, that key you found should work.
Hold for BCW.
What are you looking for exactly? Maybe I can help.
Anything about Crane. Or the witch he was using. Something. Collection.
What is that?
No idea. Pretty sure it's something they aren't supposed to have. This isn't the witch, though. J.D. This doesn't really tell us much. Butcher? What is this stuff? I'm sorry, I know I'm late. I'll get it to you soon. Ichabod Crane.
Who was he sending money to?
Crooked Man. Care of the Lucky Pawn. You know what that is?
Is that what you needed?
I don't think so, but it's interesting. There's more going on here. I still need to find that witch, though.
Hey, Bigby. Do you think, after all this, do you think I could come back to the Woodlands? Since Crane let me go, I mean, I can still work here, but I don't think I want to now. I don't want to work with bad people, you know?
You should talk to Snow. Maybe there's something she can do for you.
Really? That would be... thank you.
It's Snow's hair.
Snow White? Why...
We found her hair like this inside Lily's glamour. Anti-Greenleaf. This must be the witch Crane was using.
I guess Dee and Dumb were getting the hair for Crane and sending it to her? That's not a pleasant thought.
There's no address on it.
So what now? Snow would probably want to know about this.
I should tell Snow about this. She might need to change her locks.
Well, I can take care of that, if you want.
Maybe she can find a record on this antique Greenleaf.
I think I saw a phone near the back.
Thanks.
You're welcome, Sheriff.
Business office, this is Snow White.
Hey, Snow.
Oh, it's you. Sorry, I've been answering angry phone calls for hours. People want to know where Crane is. How'd it go with the Tweedle brothers?
No address yet, but I got a name for Crane's witch, Auntie Greenleaf. You heard of her?
No. I'll get Buffkin started looking for a record, but it might take some time.
Huh. Somebody's got to know where to find her. And Snow, I found a note with some money attached. Crane has been embezzling from Fabletown.
Of course, because... Because why half-ass being a complete sleazeball? Do you think this is tied to the murders? I mean, I guess it doesn't matter yet. We still have to find him.
I think it's connected. Maybe the girls found out about it? I don't know.
Maybe. You might want to try Holly's place. See if she hasn't burned Lily's things yet. Or Crane's. You might find something there. Although, Bluebeard's been there. I'll leave it up to you, but we don't have much time. Crane is meeting her at 2 a.m.
I'll go to the Trip Trap, see about Lily's things. I think that's our best option.
Sounds good. Just be gentle with Holly when you get there, okay? I'll give Bufkin the name and hope he finds something in the records.
Let me know what he comes up with.
I'll be in touch. I hope you'll do the same.
We'll catch him, Snow.
Bigby, I have to go. Someone just came in. Good luck.
She's asleep, you fucking idiot.
You didn't even give me a chance to explain. What's left to...
I need to talk to Holly. Hey, look, Woody, it's the sheriff. Well, come on in, buddy.
Brent.
What? He's a traveler. A weary traveler in search of some hospitality, right?
Yeah, sure. Thanks.
I want a drink. Anybody else want a drink?
Brent, Swinehart said you shouldn't mix it.
You think I give a fuck what that fucking guy says? Or what you say?
Gren, really?